Blended learning replaces expensive, complicated, and inaccessible learning techniques with much less expensive, simpler, and more convenient alternatives. The basic design principle is a brick-and-mortar facility plus online learning with student control over time, place, path, or space. It is face-to-face plus significant online components, which many have hallmarked as the best of both worlds. This type of learning is highly personalized, student-centric, and extremely productive. EDUCAUSE is an authority on the advancement of higher education through the use of information technology and has multiple bulletins by a plethora of qualified authors approving and promoting the blended learning approach. The EDUCAUSE Center for Applied Research Bulletin 2004 notes that blended learning is an evolving phenomenon that offers promise for addressing challenges such as access, cost, efficiency, and timely degree completion. This bulletin also informs us that blended learning increases student learning outcomes and decreases instructional delivery costs by 25 to 50%, increases student and instructor information literacy, lowers attrition rates in comparison with fully online courses, and keeps student and faculty satisfied with their education and teaching experiences. According to the EDUCAUSE Blended Synchronous Learning Handbook, which came out this year, many students appreciate being exposed to a broader range of perspectives, value the flexibility that blended learning affords, and in many cases feel that it leads to an enhanced sense of community. Some students report learning more in blended learning mode than in their usual classes because of the active learning tasks that their teacher designed and applied. Teachers also recognized that there were several advantages to blended learning, such as the ability to include remote students in classes, field more questions during lessons, and increase the active learning of all students. The technology was seen as a way to facilitate greater contribution by all students and increase the sense of community amongst the class. The handbook also notes that blended learning offers many advantages to institutions. It can provide more flexible access to programs, increase the amount of in-class participation, enhance students' sense of connectedness, and potentially be more financially efficient. The author of The Excellent Inevitability of Online Courses, M. Brooks, from the Chronicle of Higher Education, written back in 2009, sums up why the addition of online learning into a classroom to create blended learning is so important for our students. Her 8 reasons are: we want our students to be actively engaged in learning. The traditional teaching approach features a professor giving lectures in a class, writing notes on the blackboard, and periodically asking questions to stimulate discussion. That kind of teaching will arguably always have a place in higher education. However, other more interactive teaching methods, group projects, debates, and technology-based tools such as PowerPoint and video have evolved and gained their place in classrooms. Web and web hybrid courses simply take the trend one step further. 2, we want to reach students with diverse learning styles. 3, we want our students to have a variety of experiences outside the classroom. We should promote and recommend online courses, recognizing that students can have valuable learning experiences both in and out of the physical classroom. 4, we want to teach our students how to do independent research. Likewise, we want our graduates to be technologically literate and proficient, as well as to master subject-specific knowledge and skills. We need to teach students about the responsible use of technology and internet resources while they are in college. Web-based courses, by their very nature, provide students with hands-on opportunities to improve their proficiency in using technology and in evaluating sources of information on the internet. 5, we want to make college more accessible to students. 6, we want to make attending college more affordable. 7, we want to teach our students values and ethics. Critics claim that online courses are inferior to traditional courses because they are supposedly more susceptible to cheating. But widespread internet connectivity through laptops, cell phones, and other technologies already provides opportunities for cheating in every type of course. Students who want to cheat can find a way to do so in non-wired traditional class settings. Throughout their college experience, we need to teach our students about making wise, ethical choices and about the responsible and safe use of technology in all the courses they take. And 8, we want our students' degrees to be valued by employers. Some employers can be skeptical about the value of online learning, which makes a blended learning approach, again, the best of both worlds. In regards to nursing education, many blended learning techniques are already in use. The ATI testing, NCLEX testing prep work, PowerPoint presentations within classrooms, and simulation are all examples of blended learning techniques. But nursing education could benefit from the increased use of online teaching. Case studies, research, and teamwork would all be better orchestrated, lessons would be better retained, and students would gain technology literacy with the assistance of the online forum. Blended learning is best practice today and dynamic enough to keep up with the future.